All right, so here today we have the update information. It is now officially out. We're going to be checking out if anything is new in this update. Well, everything is new, but anything good or surprising. That's what we're going to be checking out here today. New to the channel, like and subscribe, helps out a ton. And yeah, I do appreciate it. Apparently we are close to 17K, or what are we at? We are very close to 17K. If you'd like to subscribe, it means a lot to me. Let's hop into it. So, update on January 25th. This is going to be the Dirty Backyard update. That is this over here. It goes live on 25th of January. As we have, we're getting Moran over here, and we're getting the one only Sugar. Well, technically, whoever, who knows. The new Sugar skin is coming out here, so do keep that in mind. Very cool artwork. Very cool indeed. What else are we getting in this update? Let's go through it. So again, SSR Moran, this character is the leader of the small underworld organization known as Peony Associations. Let's go with that. Joins the battlefield. The more HP Moran loses, the stronger her defense becomes. She taunts the enemies continuously and increasing her HP to survive whenever it drops below a certain point. She's a class defender. Weapon is Dragon Head AR. Code is Electric. Manufacturer Tetraline. We do have the special recruit active up until February 8th, which, by the way, February 8th should be around the Valentine's update. So do keep that in mind. Remember that, right? Now, beyond that, 4% on a 2% is how this banner is going to go, which means a 4% chance to get a Nick A. That's an SSR. In that 4%, it's going to break down to a 2%, 50-50 chance to pull Moran. Not a 1% like those Pilgrim banners. So again, if you want to go into summon, you're more than welcome to. Up to you. I don't know. But beyond that, we have the thing over here. She is not a special character. She will be available in the Ordinary Recruit. New costume, which is going to be Sugar Wild Backyard. The attire she often wore during her time in the underworld. Sugar Wild Backyard can be obtained from the February Mission Pass. You may check the new commodities information below to find out how. So again, that's the skin over here. It's already in game if you want to go and take a look into it. It's a very good looking skin in my opinion. And Sugar is one of my favorite characters. So maybe I do go for it. That is my little quick 10 cents. So just know that, all right? All right. Beyond that, we do have a new event. It's going to be the new story event, Dirty Backyard. Event is going to be, again, active from January 25th all the way up until February 8th. All right. Moran is unjustly accused as the perpetrator of a murder that unfolded in Fog Hollow of the Outer Rim. As a result, her reputation in the Outer Rim plummets and her standing in Underworld Queen becomes precarious. Determined to unravel the truth and clear her name, Moran enlists the help of Sugar, one of the scavengers. Together, they head toward Fog Hollow to uncover the, it just cuts off there. I'm guessing the murder? I don't know. The intricacies of something, of the, so I don't know what it says beyond that, but players can enter the event and win event items, which are used to exchange various rewards, such as recruit vouchers and skill manuals and stuff. Item exchange event will end again over here on February 8th. So far, very standard update. Nothing too special here. Given it's one of those updates, I'm thinking it's actually dead completely because whenever they like patch it in the game, because we knew Moran was in here. We saw her in game, right? So I'm guessing it's just going to be a very dead update because they don't have any events here. Challenge stage is going to kick up again, obviously, when the thing starts, the match or the thing. February 8th is when it ends. So keep that in mind. You can challenge that for, again, the buffed up rewards, which is very, very nice. The 7-day login event is Passionate Peony. Let's go with that. The duration is the same thing. 7-day event to log in to get recruit vouchers and development materials when you log in for 7 days straight. Remember, I would recommend highly to save these recruit vouchers for a while because I think when we get now the Valentine's update, it should just throw all these characters in when either Privity drops or the collab after if that happens. So, like, if you're skipping Aid, if you're skipping Moran, if you're skipping Leona, you can just update your entire kind of ranking there. The saddest thing is, I'm pretty sure they're all of a crappy category, correct? Like, I think they're all Tetra. So, just keep that in mind, bro. It's so annoying when they keep making these characters Tetra, right? What was Leona? Leona was Tetra. So, you have a Tetra there. You have that as a Tetra. And, yeah, just... It's not even worth it to give that as a suggestion because it's like they're all Tetra. So what's the point? Literally, what is the point? So keep that in mind. But if you already have like Blanc and Noir and most of the Tetra class, you can update it. Archives will be for the Outsiders. The Outsiders making a return here, which is very cool. So yeah, take that. Story event, The Outsiders will now be available in Archives. Participate in Dirty Backyard to obtain memory films for unlocking story events in Archives. Opening time is that January 25th. How to enter, lobby, outpost, command center, recollection, Archives. Coordinated operation is going to kick up also. You're going to be fighting Chatterbox, baby. Chatterbox coming out. So players can either team up with friends and union members or join the challenge through... Bro, why is everything getting cut off in this patch notes? Is it me? No, it's not me, right? I don't know. It just cut off. Who cares? That is going to be, again, February 2nd until the 4th. The new commodities, the new characters package will be updated over here. Sale duration is 12, January 25th, up until February 28th. Around February 28th is when we should theoretically be getting the collaboration. I don't know. So just keep that in mind, right? I don't know if they're doing that for a purpose, but yeah. February mission pass event duration is February 1st until February 29th. So a short month there. So make sure you don't miss any days. Keep that in mind. After purchasing the February premium pass, complete daily missions to level up and obtain rewards such as recruit vouchers and mold items. Win Sugar's special costume. It just cuts off. It's fine. Who gives a damn? Who gives a damn, bro? Can't even read it. But yeah, that is basically the patch notes here. It's a very small update. We knew that, I think, going into this. I think no one's shocked about the update being this small. It's because they already had the character in game. Whenever they do that, where they're like, they already show the character, they're not planning like some extravagant things because it's all been put there, right? Like, leaks would have told us what's coming out. But just know that now. As of what we know via the information floating, is that the Valentine's update is relatively close. So that's like your next big update to kind of save for and be hyped for. We don't know if that second character is limited. Right now, we don't know, but we've never had a character to break that mold. So we'll find out soon. It's all speculation as of right now. No one really knows the answer. Neither do the leakers. They don't have any information on that. And again, all that's left after that is the collaboration. So we're just waiting to find some information. Basically, around the month after, so like right when February ends, at the end of the next month, you're starting like any hype up announcement tweet time. Like, that's where you're at. So if they push back the collaboration anymore, probably it's gone and they won't do it. Like, this is the closest we've been to a potential collab without them announcing any sort of information. So it's up to them if they want to announce it, but I'm guessing they're going to wait till like the very last day of Valentine's Day and then say collab coming soon. And I think that they put Valentine's Day, if they did that, kind of have like an idea now that they know that only things that sell in their game is limited banners. Hence why limited before collab happened to bait you, because people know that, they know people are going to start saving, right? Because they have that speculation in their head, like, oh, last year around this time, getting a little bit more, you know, concrete, like this happened, things are making sense, collab is a potential, so people are saving, and devs don't want that, they want to make some money, bro, so they're throwing in a limited to potentially bait you, but again, we don't know, it's my speculation, but yeah, all right, take care, very cool patch notes, very, very cool, a standard one, nothing too special, but hey, it's here, it's fun, it's freebies, it's rewards, it's content, I guess, take it and have fun, yeah, cool.